Hey everybody, welcome back to a brand new episode of Guitar Battles. And this week we have a very interesting comparison because we are going to compare two classics, the D18 and the Hummingbird Original. They share a lot of similarities and yet we're going to talk about the differences as well, so it's going to be very cool.
Yep.
So these two guitars share a lot in common. They're both dreadnoughts, they both have Sitka tops, mahogany back and sides, mahogany necks.
Yep.
But then there are also a lot of differences and let's go through them. What the differences are and what they do with the sound. Let's kick off with what's most visible in the eye. It's the ebony fretboard versus the rosewood fretboard and bridge. So the ebony is a bit stiffer and gives a bit more projective tone, so it really fits the Martin Dreadnought well because it's a very loud instrument and very strong instrument. The rosewood is a bit sweeter, it has some top chime. So the next big difference between these two guitars is that the Martin is a long scale guitar and the Hummingbird is a short scale guitar, and that combined with the fretboards makes a lot of difference because a short scale you need less tension to get the same tone, so you already get a somewhat softer, more mellow tone, whereas with a longer scale you get some more punch, some more bass. You need to work a little bit harder because you have more tension, but with a good setup it shouldn't matter a lot.
Under the hood, they're both scalloped X bracing.
Well, the Gibson Hummingbird is an awesome instrument and it's really well known for recording. The short scale combined with how it's braced, with the mahogany and Sitka top as well, the blend together makes it a unique tone and it makes it really gentle. So it's not, you know, you look at it as a dreadnought when you come from the Martin side. I think, well, it's a dreadnought, it should make a lot of noise. Well, it doesn't.
Yeah.
But it doesn't matter because it's about the tone that's in there and it's a really nice, warm, mellow tone. So if you're a singer-songwriter who wants, who isn't a big strummer, who's not a bluegrasser, then this can be an ideal guitar because it gives a big sound, it's just not loud.
This one isn't gentle.
No, no, it's like a real American
V8. Yeah, it's a cannon, but it does sound very good.
Yeah.
I will always be a D18 man.
That brings us to the final piece of this video, the 30 second pitch.
The pitch.
Or shall we make it a 30 minute pitch?
No. 30 seconds is, we'll I don't need any more.
So the Gibson Hummingbird is the ideal instrument if you're a singer-songwriter, you're not into bluegrass, and you're more into Americana, the softer, gentle playing styles. It's warm, it's mellow, and yet you have a big guitar in your hands, which feels warm and strong, and you know, it brings enough. Also a big plus compared to the Martin that comes with built-in electronics, they come with the yellow bags installed, which is really nice as well, and it's built to last.
Okay, the Martin D-AT. It's been built like this for over 80 years and not a lot has changed. It's the classic American guitar. The body shape is instantly recognizable. It's got that classic American tone. No electronics. This is old school work. Mahogany, it can be warm, but if you push it a little bit, it can be very loud as well if you're playing in a bluegrass setting or more of a folk setting. It's just clean, minimalistic, but always a classic.
So that was it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed the guitars. Which one did you like it most? Let us know. And also why you liked it most. If you want to get some more details on the guitars and more specs, we have some recordings of them as well. Go to our website and we hope to see you in the next video.
Or in the store.